Good morning. Please stand.
Entre tus manos está mi vida, Señor. Entre tus manos pongo mi existir. Hay que morir para vivir. Entre tus manos confío mi ser. Si el grano de trigo entre tus manos está mi vida, Señor. Entre tus manos pongo mi existir. Hay que morir para vivir. Entre tus manos confío mi ser.
En el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo, la gracia de nuestro Señor Jesucristo, el amor del Padre y la comunión del Espíritu Santo estén con todos ustedes. I welcome everyone this morning to St. John Jude's Parish as we celebrate the life of Edward Pedamonte. My name's Father Ethan. I'm the administrator here at the parish. And Adriana and Kaylee and Oswaldo, to the family, friends. I know there's people joining us live stream from Colombia and afar, and so we welcome you all today. As we gather on this difficult morning to celebrate a life that was taken too soon. And I know many of us are confused and there's a lot of questions. There's more questions why than answers that we have. And we're not able to make sense of why certain things happen. But we are certain that God is with us and that God does love us, even in the midst of a confusing, difficult time. So as we prepare to enter into these mysteries, as we prepare to celebrate the life of Edward, let's pause for just a moment reflecting on our own lives. Maybe those moments where we haven't been as kind as we should, or maybe we've said a word or two that wasn't filled with love. And let's ask God for his mercy and for his forgiveness and just the grace to try again with his help. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Señor Dios, en tu amorosa providencia, nos diste a Edward para que
creciera en sabiduría, edad y gracia. Ahora que lo has llamado a tu presencia, dale su plenitud en Cristo con todos los ángeles y santos que conocen tu amor y glorifican tu voluntad salvadora. Por Jesucristo nuestro Señor. Amén. Please be seated for the readings. And Connor, I think you have the first reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The just ones, though one dies early, shall be at rest. For the age that is honorable comes not with the passing of time, nor can it be measured in terms of years. Rather, understanding is a hoary crown for them, and an unsullied life the attainment of old age. The one who pleased God was loved, who lived among sinners was transported, snatched away, lest wickedness pervert one's mind or deceit beguile one's soul. For the witchery of paltry things obscures what is right, and the whirl of desire transforms the innocent mind. Having become perfect in a short while, when we reach the fullness of a long career, for the soul was pleasing to the Lord. Therefore, God sped her out in the midst of wickedness, but the people saw and did not understand, nor did they take this into account. The word of the Lord.
Let us go. Because they said to me, we will go up to the house of the Lord. And now we have set foot within your gates, O Jerusalem. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Jerusalem, built as a city with compact unity, to which the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the according to the decree for Israel, to give thanks to the name of the Lord. In it are set up judgment seats, seats for the house of David. Let us go
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los tesalonicenses. Hermanos y hermanas, no queremos que ignoren lo que pasa con los difuntos, para que no vivan tristes, como los que no tienen esperanza. Pues sí creemos que Jesús murió y resucitó. De igual manera, debemos creer que a los que mueren en Jesús, Dios los llevará con él. Lo que les decimos como palabra del Señor es esto: que nosotros, los que quedemos vivos para cuando venga el Señor, no tendremos ninguna ventaja sobre los que ya murieron. Cuando Dios mande que suenen las trompetas, se oirá la voz de un arcángel, y el Señor mismo bajará del cielo. Entonces, los que quedemos vivos seremos arrebatados juntamente con ellos entre nubes, por el aire, para ir al encuentro del Señor, y así estaremos siempre con Él. Consuélense, pues, unos a otros con esas palabras. Palabra de Dios.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. When the soldiers came to the place called the Skull, they crucified Jesus and the criminals there, one on his right, the other on his left. Now one of the criminals hanging there reviled Jesus, saying, "Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us." The other man, however, rebuking him, said in reply, "Have you no fear of God? For you are subject to the same condemnation. And indeed, we have been condemned justly, for the sentence we received corresponds to our crimes. But this man has done nothing criminal." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus replied to him, "Amen, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." The Gospel of the Lord. Those words that we hear, "Today you will be with me in paradise," are an assurance from Jesus that Edward is with Christ. Edward was with Christ in a death like his, a death which Jesus himself was taken too young, premature, and it wasn't fair. A death where Jesus left his friends, his family, his loved ones. And there was a great hole left behind. And there was such potential that Jesus had with him. In a sense, his ministry was only beginning. He was teaching, he was healing, he was helping people. And more came to believe in God through Jesus, and they were following him. And right at the cusp of such great potential, Jesus' life was taken from him. And Edward had so much potential, so much life and so much love. He loved his family. And he loved his friends. He loved to travel and he loved to learn and to read. Adriano is just sharing with me just before the Mass began about how he's on the robotics team and he just loved physics and math and just the whole idea of energy and the whole universe, all the mysteries, all the secrets of the universe being unlocked and explored, and how to use all of that energy and to create such potential. And here we are today. This difficult, this painful, this confusing day. And so it's fitting that we heard from that reading in the gospel as Jesus was there on Golgotha. And we're told in another part of that reading that the sky grew dark. And in a lot of ways, I think our world has grown dark. It's been a difficult year for all of us. And the hope that we have where things could start to open up or we could go back to normal, things can't go back the way they were. There won't be a normal like we've known it. We can't pick up all of the pieces that have fallen apart this last year. There's a prayer that we'll pray in the Eucharistic prayer today. And it talks about how God's love is with us from the rising of the sun. You think about a beautiful day, all the potential that comes with the dawn. We see that sun rise, the light begin to go across the whole world. And as much joy as we can fit into that day, we know that at some point, the sun will set. And it will get dark. And the day will come to an end. But I'm not a great mathematician or a physicist. I'm sure some of you are Edward's classmates here, and you're probably pretty smart with math and science, but I know that energy can't be destroyed. It changes, but it comes up in another way. So it just continues on in a different way. There's another prayer in the Mass that says, life has changed, but it doesn't end. So this candle that we have here today, I love this image. This candle was lit when the sun had set, at Jesus' death on Holy Saturday, the darkest day that there ever had been. So in that dark day, in that evening of Holy Saturday, we celebrate the resurrection with the Paschal fire, and we had it in the plaza. So this fire comes forth, this symbolizing a new life coming forth. And this candle was lit from that Paschal fire to remind us of the life of Christ. This candle is lit at baptisms. It was lit at Edward's baptism. Because in his baptism, there was a death to an old way of life, and there was the gift of a new life, a divine life, the life of Christ that he received in his baptism. This candle is lit again today to remind us of that life with Christ. And Edward's life has changed. All of our lives have changed. But his life has not ended. And as we heard in the gospel, Jesus say, "You will be with me in paradise." I invite everyone to please stand, and we have our petitions. I'm not sure if anyone's reading the petitions. Christina? Sorry, are you reading? Do you have them? Yeah, come. She's going to read. Come. And you've got the list? Okay. Oh, no, this is after. Yeah, okay, thank you.
Oremos por Edward, por su familia y amigos y por todo el pueblo de Dios.
For Edward, child of God and heir to the kingdom, that he be held securely in God's loving embrace now and for all eternity. We pray to the Lord. For Edward's family, especially his mother Adriana, father Oswaldo, and his sister Kaylee, that they feel the healing power of Christ in the midst of their pain and grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Edward's friends, those who grew with him, studied with him, played with him, who cared for him, that they may be consoled in their loss and strengthened in their love for one another. We pray to the Lord. For all parents who grieve over the death of their children, that they may be comforted in the knowledge that their children dwell with God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole church, that we prepare worthily for the hour of our death, when God will call us by name to pass from this world to the next. We pray to the Lord. Por Edward, hijo de Dios y heredero del reino, para que sea recibido en el abrazo amoroso de Dios ahora y por toda la eternidad. Roguemos al Señor. Por la familia de Edward, especialmente por su madre Adriana y su padre Oswaldo, su hermana Kaylee, para que en el medio de su pena y dolor sientan el poder sanador de Cristo. Roguemos al Señor.
Rogamos, Señor.
Por los amigos de Edward, los que con él creció y estudió, para que sean consolados en su aflicción y fortalecidos en su mutuo amor. Roguemos al Señor.
Rogamos, Señor. Lord God, you entrusted Edward to our care, and now you embrace him in your love. Take Edward into your keeping, together with all children who have died. Comfort us, your sorrowing servants, who seek to do your will and to know your saving peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And you may please be seated for the preparation of the gifts.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Mira con bondad, Señor, las ofrendas que te presentamos por tu siervo, Edward, para que, purificado por los auxilios celestiales, viva para siempre feliz en tu gloria, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Those of you who would like to kneel, you're invited to kneel. If you'd rather be seated, you may be seated now. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Del mismo modo, acabada la cena, tomó el cáliz, dando gracias te bendijo, y lo pasó a sus discípulos, diciendo, tomen y beban todos de él, porque este es el cáliz de mi sangre, sangre de alianza nueva y eterna, que será derramada por ustedes y por muchos, para el perdón de los pecados. Hagan esto en conmemoración mía. Este es el misterio de la fe.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until
everyone to stand. When Jesus came into this world, he made us part of God's own family. He gave us a dignity beyond we could imagine. And so it's because of that confidence that we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. But lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope at the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us give each other a sign of peace. Dense fraternamente la paz. This is the communion rite. I know there's probably people joining us who may not be Catholic. Everyone's invited to participate. For those of you who are Catholic and would like to receive the Eucharist, we invite you to come forward just like you normally would. Just please keep your masks on and you could receive the host in your hand. For those of you who are not Catholic, or for those who are not prepared to receive the Eucharist today, please come forward for a blessing. Just let me know that you'd like a blessing. Have your arms crossed, and we'll give you a blessing. And we're going to begin in the front, and then we're going to work. You'll go to your sides, and then come to the middle. And we're going to start in the front and just work our way to the back. And our ministers will help to guide you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Edward may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. I invite everyone to be seated, and I think we have a few words to share.
Thank you, everybody, for being here. My name is Michelle, and I'm Edward's cousin. I have a letter here from Edward's mom, Adriana, that I'd like to read. First, she'd like to say thank you to all for coming. Thank you to everyone joining us virtually as well. And our family wishes to express our heartfelt thanks to those of you who have given your support, your love, your prayers, during this really difficult time. Adriana says, nobody wants to say goodbye to their children, but sometimes God has other plans for them. As a mother, one of the happiest moments was when Edward came into this world. I was going to the university working on my second degree when I was pregnant with him. When he was older, I remembered joking with him that he was so smart because I used to take him to my mathematics, my logic, my finance, and my statistic classes. Since he was little, he had a love for electricity, computers, programming, and math. When he was in elementary school, he was able to memorize a book called Getting Started in Electronics. He loved reading, and I enjoyed buying him books from Harry Potter, including books that were numerical methods for scientists and engineering, mathematical, physics, and cybersecurity books. He started reading at college level since he was in middle school. And if you knew Edward, you knew he was self-taught. He was a perfectionist. You know, he'd master everything he touched. He even figured out how to fix his cell phones. And most of you might remember his cell phone that had that big old battery on it. He added that to the cell phone to make it last for days and days. He learned to play the piano in elementary school and in middle school. He kind of stopped playing. But before doing that, he told his piano teacher that he wanted to learn the longer version of For Elise. And this was dedicated to his grandmother, his sister, and his mother, because they're all named Elizabeth, or after Elizabeth. His recital was beautiful, and we still feel goosebumps every time we hear that song. A few years later, he started to play the piano again, and he had a keyboard in his room, played every night for hours, and she said, I don't know how his sister Kaylee managed to sleep with the noise, but perhaps it was because she loved her brother so much. I enjoyed watching him playing anime songs on the piano with his dog Xander at his side. And the piano hasn't been played since he left, but I'm sure Xander misses him terribly. I'm proud of him and all of his achievements. He enjoyed being with his friends, being in the robotics team at Chaminade, and going to their tournaments. He was a moderator in many chat rooms, and he also liked to cook. He would make pasta, pizza, donuts, and pretzels from scratch quite frequently. He wanted to pursue a degree in physics and mathematics, and I recently received a letter from Valley College where he began attending since the summer of 2019, stating that he excelled in math and science and earning high marks in linear algebra, symbolic logic, and economics. He was going to transfer to Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, and we were all looking forward to watching Edward grow, develop, and become a physicist, engineer, mathematician, or Lord knows whatever he wanted to be. Edward had a big heart, and he helped many people. Everybody that I talked to, told her the good memories that they had with him. And those were the times that he would want us to remember. Edward was with me, with his sister, when we needed him the most. And this past year we spent together will always be memorable. Thank you for making the last Christmas and New Year's special. Thank you, God, for the 18 years with Edward. As he would have said, Mom, to be exact, it's 18 years, 6 months, 3 days, and 3 minutes, or 6,759 days. I feel very blessed to be his mother, and I know I have an angel in heaven. May he rest in peace, and I love you, my baby.
Nos gustaría agradecerles a todos los que se encuentran aquí reunidos y a todos los que se unen a nosotros de manera virtual. Mi familia desea expresar nuestro más sincero agradecimiento a todos los que nos han brindado su apoyo, amor y sus oraciones durante este momento tan difícil. Esto es algo especial que escribió la mamá de Edward. Nadie quiere despedirse de sus hijos, pero a veces Dios tiene otros planes para ellos. Como madre, uno de los momentos más felices fue cuando Edward llegó a mi vida. Yo estaba yendo a la universidad para obtener mi segundo título universitario cuando estaba embarazada de él. Cuando fue mayor, recuerdo que bromeábamos de que él era tan inteligente porque él había asistido a todas las clases de matemáticas, lógica, finanzas y estadística conmigo. Desde que era niño le gustaba la electricidad, computadoras, programación y matemáticas. Cuando estaba en primaria se memorizó el libro Comenzando con la electrónica. A él gustaba la lectura y yo disfrutaba comprándole libros de Harry Potter hasta los libros de métodos numéricos para científicos e ingenieros, física y seguridad cibernética. Él comenzó a leer libros de la universidad desde que estaba en sexto grado. Si conociste a Edward, sabrás que era un autodidacta, un perfeccionista que dominaba todo lo que tocaba. Él aprendió a reparar celulares y todos los que los conocimos podemos recordar la batería grande que le puso a su celular para que durara varios días. Aprendió a tocar el piano cuando estaba en primaria y cuando empezó el bachillerato lo dejó. Antes de hacer eso, le dijo a su maestra de piano que quería aprender la versión larga de Für Elise para dedicársela a su abuela, hermana y su madre, ya que todas llevamos el nombre Elizabeth. Su recital fue hermoso. Todavía sentimos la piel de gallina cada vez que escuchamos esa canción. Unos años más tarde, él comenzó a tocar el piano de nuevo. Tenía un teclado digital en su cuarto y cada noche tocaba durante horas. No sé cómo su hermana Kaylee podía dormir con ese ruido, tal vez porque ella quería a su hermano inmensamente. Disfruté viéndolo tocar canciones de anime en el piano con su perro Xander a su lado. El piano no ha vuelto a sonar desde que él se fue. Estoy segura de que Xander también te extraña. Al igual que tus 5 gatos. Estoy orgullosa de él y de todos sus logros. Edward disfrutaba estar con sus amigos, estar en el equipo de robótica de Jaminat e ir a sus torneos. Fue moderador en diferentes chats. También le gustaba cocinar. Hacía pasta, pizza, donuts y pretzels desde cero. Quería obtener una licenciatura en física y matemáticas. Recientemente recibí una carta de la universidad donde comenzó en el 2019 que mencionaba que él se destacó en matemáticas y ciencia ganando altas calificaciones en álgebra lineal, lógica simbólica y economía. Iba a trasladarse a Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. Todos estábamos mirando su futuro, viendo a Edward crecer, desarrollarse y convertirse en un físico, ingeniero, matemática o simplemente lo que él quería ser. Edward tenía un gran corazón y ayudó a muchas personas. Todas las personas con las que he hablado tienen buenos recuerdos de él. Esos son los tiempos que él quiere que recordemos. Edward estuvo conmigo y con su hermana cuando más lo necesitábamos. Este último año que pasamos juntos fue y siempre será memorable. Gracias por hacer que la última Navidad y Año Nuevo fueran tan especiales. Dios, gracias por darme a Edward por 18 años. Como él hubiera dicho, mamá, para ser exactos son 18 años, 6 meses, 3 días, 3 minutos o 5,6.759 días. Me siento muy afortunada de ser su madre. Sé que tengo un ángel en el cielo. Descansa en paz. Te amo, mi Pepe.
Gracias, Cristina. Gracias, Michelle. Y antes de separarnos, despámbanos de nuestro hermano Edward, que nuestro último adiós exprese nuestro afecto por él, mitigue nuestra tristeza y fortalezca nuestra esperanza. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. To your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Edward in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. Te damos gracias por todos los dones que lo enriqueciste a lo largo de su vida. En ellos reconocemos un signo de tu amor y de la comunión de los santos. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Again, I just express my condolences on behalf of our parish and our school. I thank you all for being here today. And we continue to keep the family, the friends. We keep Edward in our hearts and our prayers. And we ask for our Blessed Mother Mary to be with us and to comfort us as she comforted and she received comfort at the loss of her son. And so together we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless and keep you in his sacred heart, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
My refuge, my
Christos ten.